Winner sa kwentuhan, mga buluhang talakayan. Napapanahong issue na pinag-uusapan ng bawat tahanan. I always for the win!
Ang oras po natin, 10:25, kasama niyo pa rin Tita Winnie Cordero para sa Win Today. Olympic fever pa, Olympic mode pa rin po tayo ngayon. Eh alam niyo, nandito ngayon ang isa sa mga hairstylist and of course traveler ng mga atleta at iba pang mga celebrities abroad. Narito ta bumibisita siya at sa Pilipinas si Lance Jamiel or JB Bustos. Hello JB, welcome to the Philippines.
Hey, how are you?
Hi! Hey. Yeah, there you are. Kailan ka pa nakauwi?
I just got back to the Manila. It's 2 days ago.
Two days for vacation.
No, not for vacation. Just here for work.
Yeah, for work?
For work. Yeah. Really? As soon as I landed, I got the opportunity to meet Manny Pacquiao, legend himself, and then I'm just here to meet more stars and bring some inspiration to the country.
Oh, are you going to stay longer?
Yes, my plan, I booked a one-way flight here, so I just want to see what else I can do out here in Manila.
Is that for good?
Yes.
Not for good,
but like just to...
Just try.
Just to see
what... Test the waters.
Yes, exactly.
Why?
I haven't been back, it's been about 8 years, and I have a lot of family here.
Uh-huh.
And I just wanted to go back to my roots, and like, because I'm from Quezon City, and I wanted to see how it's like to be back home, and see the people again, and just tap back into the culture.
So how are your 2 days so far?
Oh, I love it. It's amazing. It's beautiful. The weather is amazing. The people are amazing. The food is like the best.
The food is the best. Are you interested with that shrimp Bicol Express?
Oh, yeah. That looked pretty good.
That looked pretty good. And it says here in the background that I got from Bea that Manny Pacquiao was really your inspiration in pursuing your career. How so?
Yes. When I first started my journey traveling around the world, meeting loads of successful people, Manny brought me hope as a Pinoy. He brought me hope that I'm able to reach any levels of success, no matter where you're from, no matter your upbringing, you know, to just keep fighting and keep going.
Really? Yeah. So you must have seen all his fights.
Yes, I have. All the family gatherings all over the world, you know how it is.
That's right. Yeah. But you are not an athlete. You pursued a different type of career, right?
Yes.
And that is hairstyling.
Yes, exactly.
So, what are the difficulties that you have to undergo or you have experienced in your journey?
I mean, I applied the same mindset as Pacquiao, right? To from nothing to something, to keep working, right? It doesn't matter what field you're in, whether you're a hairstylist or a fighter or a basketball player.
Mm-mm.
You know, as long as you keep working hard and do it for your family, you know, that's all that matters.
Kwento mo naman, JB, kasi sabi dito, grabe yung mga kakliyente mo, ha, doon sa Amerika. At balita ko ikaw mismo ang hinahanap nila. Paano mo narating yung ganyang stage sa iyong career? And you are what? 20? How old are you now?
Yes, I'm 20.
20 years old, diba?
Yeah. It's all about the network. It's meeting people,
network.
You know?
Network.
It's I meet you and then, you know, maybe you know someone and like... Word of mouth. Exactly. Just about meeting people, making new friends and just being Filipino, you know? We Filipinos are very nice, you know, we're very nice people,
friendly,
and we got to take that and use it as an advantage to be able to make friends all over the world.
Really? Was it easy for you to make friends?
Wasn't
there any discrimination or awkwardness, like, who is this guy?
Of course, throughout the whole journey, of course, you know, but it just be a great person, you know, just be a great person and just be yourself.
Na nosebleed ako. Wait lang. Be yourself. Who was your most difficult customer?
Most difficult customer. I don't think I've had any difficult customers. Yes, everyone's pretty easygoing.
Really?
Yes.
like, you didn't have any problems? Like, they didn't like the way you cut their hair or so, something?
No, I don't think so. Maybe in the very beginning, when I first started. But not so far.
Paano? Like, did you attend any seminar classes?
I learned just through experience and practice. I did it myself. Practice on my family and my relatives, and then after, just work from
practice
there.
Practice on, I like that. Practice on your friends and relatives.
Yeah.
Ano naman yung reaction nila during practice?
I mean, it was, you know, we all start from somewhere. When you first start something, you're not the greatest, you know, but you have to keep going.
Of course.
You know, to get better.
Eh, paano pag wala nang relative at saka friends na mag-practice? Did then, you run out of practice people?
Yeah, so I do myself.
Oh, you do
on my
yourself,
own. You know,
okay.
I would mess up my own, make myself look bad.
And then, how do you update your styling?
Update?
Yeah, because it's fashion, right? Mm. There's a trend. There is, so you have to update your styles, your knowledge every now and then. So how do you do that? Also in the internet?
Yes, of course. Yes, Instagram, TikTok. Mm. All the trends are on our cell phones today.
Okay.
So
yeah. You haven't really attended any formal classes for this?
No, I believe I didn't have any money growing up. So going to
in
school
Canada?
In Canada. So going to school, going to barber school was quite a little bit expensive. So I used the resources that I had, which is my cell phone, YouTube.
And now that you have the money, do you have plans to go to school?
School, I believe you should go to school if you are going into a field that is school is necessary for that occupation.
Mm-mm.
But if you want to do something like, for example, be an entrepreneur or create content creator, I wouldn't need school for that, you know?
Really?
But,
okay, yeah. At 20, did you plan this stage in your career at 20 years old? Or did you have this vision that at 20, I will be this?
At 20, I didn't think I was going to become this far.
Okay.
You know, God is good, God is great. And I just sometimes things just keep going for you and you have to keep up with the momentum.
Mm-hmm.
And when you get that momentum, just keep feeding the fire. Just
wow.
Keep going.
Parang Olympian din, di ba? Grabe. So what's next for JB?
What's next is I'm going to continue traveling the world. I'm going to continue to spread more motivation and positivity, represent the Pinoy community. I would like to meet some more stars here in Manila. More successful people out here in Manila or in the whole Philippines. I want to open up a barbershop here as well.
Oh, yeah?
And, you know, make other people feel confident, you know?
Well, good luck to you,
Thank
guys.
Thank you very much.
You are so young. I want to clap my hands for you. Thank you so young.
Thank
Do you
for
want
having
to
me.
Greet some of your relatives, friends who are here in the Philippines?
Yes. Hi, Ninong. Hi, Ninang. How are you guys? My cousins. I know you guys see me right now. Love you guys.
Okay.
I do this for you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, JB, for the time.
Thank you very much.
And good luck. Good
Thank
luck
you so
to
much.
Your journey. Sige.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Si Lance Jamiel, JB Bustos po, ang isang athlete and celebrity hairstylist and traveler, wants to make it big. Actually, he's already big at 20 years old. Imagine that. Thank you,
Thank
JB.
You. Okay.
More power to you. Up next. Subscribe na sa Teleradyo Serbisyo YouTube channel.